The late night television climate is certainly in the midst of change. Fans are adjusting to the absence of some of their favorite hosts. Chelsea Handler and Craig Ferguson have already taken their last bow. And it's the countdown right now to the final episode for David Letterman of The Late Show. Jon Stewart says adios to The Daily Show in August. In the midst of all these changes, there happens to be a local comedic variety show which appears to be a spinoff of sorts of late night television. But this show is on the web. And the guests are all from Rochester. The online program is called Rochester Live. Take a look.
It's Rochester Live.
Welcome to the show.
On today's show, from Channel 8 News, Natasha Alford.
Welcome to the show.
And your host, Ron Ferrara.
Hi, Ron. Hey, Mike. Hello, everybody. Hello. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, come on. Too much. Thank you for coming. Appreciate it. Welcome back to another episode of Rochester Live. We're excited to be here. Back for our second episode now. Hey, with me as always, Mike Scipione and the Genesee River Boys. How's it going, boys? Let's get this started. There's a lot bugging me. A lot going on right now.
Really?
Yeah. You could even say that there's a lot on my nerves. Take a look at what's on my nerves. You know what's on my nerves right now? The cold. It's freezing outside. You can see your breath indoors. It's ridiculous. You've seen her on Channel 8. Here she is, Natasha Alford. Thank you so much for coming. Please have a seat. Welcome. Welcome to the show. Everyone knows you from Channel 8, where thousands of people see you. But this is the internet, where millions of people watch. So welcome to the big leagues.
Joining me to discuss the concept of Rochester Live, how it's being received in our area, and how the web has the ability to grow this type of programming beyond our community. I'm joined by Rochester Live host Ron Ferrara and journalist Leah Stacy, who also serves as a professor of communications and media at Nazareth College. And thank you both for being here.
Thanks for having us.
So Ron, just to begin, I have to ask about the concept for Rochester Live and how it developed. You call it this organically grown show with the finest hand pick guests and ethically sourced jokes. So talk a little bit about why you thought this would be a good fit for Rochester.
You know, there's so many interesting things going on in Rochester and so many cool people that are out there, and there really isn't a program like it, at least not in a comedic capacity. Not that we're super funny, but it's nice to put a sarcastic spin on things and, you know, say things that people aren't usually allowed to say on TV.
Well, in watching your previous episodes, it's clear you play your role as host very straight. It's also as though you're paying homage to The Tonight Show. And at the same time, though, you're mimicking the show as well. So I wanted to know, is that your goal, or is there one that you prefer to do more of over the other?
I mean, if we could get paid to do it full time, yeah, I'd love to do The Tonight Show, absolutely. But no real end goal. We're just having fun with it. You know, just an idea that we wanted to run with and see how Rochester received it. And I think we're having a lot of luck so far.
Okay, well, we'll get into that in just a moment. I want to ask you, Leah, in your opinion, what type of influence and impact do you think that a web TV show like this can have in Rochester? I mean, it's got the comedy, the satire, local faces, the band. You know, you discuss local news topics at times. I guess, how can the Rochester residents really connect to it?
Well, I think that they've done a great job of staying relevant. The guests have been varied. And I personally connected to it because these are people my age doing this. And, you know, if I bring that up in class, it's really neat for my students to see, you know, here's people a couple years out of college, and they're just doing this. They don't have a full budget. They can't, you know, they don't have a full production team, but they're launching it on the web. And, you know, we're seeing so many people cutting the cord now. So it's awesome that it's on the web, because you can watch it any time that works for you. I can show it in class. It's just, I think it's so neat. And he's right, there's nothing like it here.
And who is your ideal audience?
Everybody. We try to play to everybody. You know, we try to keep the jokes open to any audience member, not just cater to one particular crowd. We want it to be relatable, just to anybody who lives in Rochester or the area who's gonna get it.
And how, I have to ask, how do you get your guests to go along with some of your jokes? So I saw when Adam Chodak was on from 13 Wham, I mean, you guys are talking, having this casual conversation as what appears to be icing and it's being caked all over your face. I mean, what kind of waiver are they signing?
None. And I got to give Adam huge props on doing that. We don't usually prepare the guests ahead of time with any of that sort of thing, because though it's not actually live, we shoot it as if it is. So we cut to commercial break and said, hey, Adam, here's the idea we want to go with. Either we can both do this or I'm doing this, but one of us is getting frosting on our faces. And he was a good sport about it, thankfully, and we got away with it somehow.
Leah, is there a sense that locally grown programs like Rochester Live that have a late night TV show like style or feel is part of this larger pool of web TV shows that we're seeing right now? I'm curious to find out whether you think this is a style that's growing and could maybe expand even beyond Rochester.
Yeah, well, it's, you know, it's always been a popular thing, especially with the college age. And, you know, the fact that we don't have to see the band going out in between the segments and interviewing people in the streets of New York City, but it's East Ave, you know, it's university. It's the places that are familiar to us and maybe people that we know, maybe it's our next door neighbor getting stopped on the street. You know, I think that you start locally and then they're picking relevant topics and topics that can put Rochester in a national spotlight. And I think that's where it gets really cool because you can take it and launch it. And then the web gives you this platform to just send it anywhere. You know, anybody can watch this.
So talk about how it is being received. What type of feedback are you getting? And I guess, how do you measure the reactions from the local community?
It's been fun. Just, you know, feedback from friends and family. Everyone seems to love it. And then, you know, people reaching out to us just to say, hey, we've seen your show. It's incredible. I've only been recognized in public once, but it took me aback.
Because
they're like,
far.
Show? What show? What are you talking about? Oh, that show. Yeah.
Right.
I forgot about that. But yeah, it's been exciting. You know, we're kind of going with the fake it till you make it kind of premise, and it seems to be working. Everyone believes that we're a talk show, so it's working for us.
I want viewers to get a sense of what goes into the production, because you were mentioning we build the set every time we come in here.
Yes, so we only shoot once a month just because of time and budget. The whole show's done out of pocket by the cast and crew. And the space that we rent, it's basically an empty room. We have to set it up every time. So we come in a few hours early, we hang lights and curtains and build the furniture and have to get it ready to go each episode. And there's usually a few writer meetings that precede that. So it's more than just a one-day ordeal. It usually takes the whole month to prepare.
Oh, very good. It's entertaining. I've enjoyed it, the episodes that I've seen. So Leah Stacy and Ron Ferrara, thank you so much for joining me. And you can check out previous episodes of Rochester Live at rochesterlive.tv. They're also on Facebook and Twitter, where you can learn more about upcoming guests.